I am so excited. I've wanted to talk about this subject for a while, but man, I knew when I planned it, this was one of the ones I got the most excited about when I planned this back in the summer, about this topic of when I was growing up. Is it gonna do the rest of it? When I was growing up, you guys are too young for this. So I didn't get to watch much
this
TV.
This station is conducting a test of the emergency broadcasting system. This is only a test.
All right. You guys don't remember this. Sam's too young to even remember this. But in my house, you know, we didn't get to watch TV really except for maybe on some Saturdays. We had to get up and milk and then go to school, and you played ball, and then you had to milk again, and then, you know, we just didn't get to watch a lot of TV. But on Saturdays, we would, and we only had four channels, you know, on TV back then. You only had four channels. It was the local channels. That's all you had. But every Saturday, this would come on. Anybody remember that, Ed?
Oh, yeah, I do.
Anybody? Me and you may be the only ones in Kent. Kent? You may remember, too. And Derry, forgive me. But so this would come on, and it would say, this is only a test. This is a test of the emergency broadcast system, and they're just testing in case there was an emergency that they could get to you. This is only a test, is what it would say. There's a story in Genesis of Abraham that confuses me a little, I'll be honest. It troubles me as a parent of three daughters who I love dearly. And I honestly believe I would give my life for them at a moment's notice. I believe that. I hope I never have to, but I do believe that I would. It's a whole nother story. It's a whole nother story if you're talking about the flip side of that. That's why this story gives me a cause for concern, for pause. Sometime later, God tested Abraham. Listen to that word. God tested Abraham. He said to him, Abraham, here I am, Lord. God said, I want you to take your son, your only son, whom you love. Isaac is his name. And I want you to go to the region of Moriah, and I want you to put him on the offering as a burnt offering and sacrifice him on the mountain I will show you. Boy, that troubles me. I'm not crazy about that story. But see, I have the human mentality where at some point in my mind, we kind of think, well, we're putting God on trial there, we're testing his character when his character is infallible. It's really us that's being tested. And see, a test, guys, is just an opportunity for a testimony. If you pass the test, you get a testimony. If you fail the test, let's try it again. That's the way God works. You pass the test, man, you get a testimony and you get to share it. You fail the test, we're going to have another test. He's not going to just let you just move on. We got to have another test. It's the same way in grades. And unfortunately, we typically don't get a test on the mountaintop of victory. Most of the tests come in the valleys. They come in the wilderness like Moses. They come on the Sea of Galilee like Peter. Or they come on this mountainside like Abraham. So the test, man, it's an opportunity for God to prove himself to us. But guess what? It's also, it's an opportunity for us to prove ourselves to God. It's the same with a football team. What do you find your identity in? What do you find your security in? What do you cling to? Is it social media? Come on, be honest. Is it drugs? Is it marijuana? Here we are in the middle of the season, and I'm telling you the stuff that will destroy us. It's our own self. It's our own self. It's our own desires. It's our own stuff. When we start looking at self, 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 and I run to marijuana, I run to alcohol, I abuse women, or I don't respect women, those things along with academics, those things along with what does social media say about me, what does it say about us, they can destroy us. They can destroy you. And the moral of this story is, man, whatever your Isaac is, lay it down. Be willing to lay it down, man, and just try, just test God in this. Trust him for a change. One thing I know is, man, God will go after anything that you trust more than Him. He will go after anything that you trust more than Him until you put it down on the altar. I've often prayed, Lord, don't let my gifts take me further than my character can sustain me. And I pray the same for you. I love the song, man. I love some of y'all singing to the praise song that we had a couple weeks ago, because whatever you don't turn into praise that God's blessed you with, it turns into pride. And pride is an issue for us men. So what is your God-given gifts, opportunities, and dreams? Those are your Isaacs. Lay them down. The truth of the matter is, we can't say mine about anything. Not your clothes, not your car, not your money. It's all His. And so we're faced as a test this week. How will you prepare? So, man, I'm asking you to strain to win, to pass the test this week of handling success and understanding what comes with preparing to play a team that can beat you. Let's pass the test this week. This is only a test.
Tell Jake to make sure the tarp's ready. We'll check with the weather service by 5, and we'll make a decision then. Hey. What you doing here? Don't you have practice?
Not anymore. I quit.
Oh. Well, since when are you the quitting kind?
I don't know. I just don't see the point anymore.
So you didn't make the dress list. There are greater tragedies in the world.
I wanted to run out of that tunnel for my dad. To prove to everyone
prove
that I worked...
what?
That I was somebody.
Oh, you are so full of crap. You're 5 feet nothing. 100 and nothing. And you got hardly a speck of athletic ability. And you hung in with the best college football team in the land for 2 years. And you're also gonna walk out of here with a degree from the University of Notre Dame. In this lifetime, you don't have to prove nothing to nobody except yourself. And after what you've gone through, if you haven't done that by now, it ain't gonna never happen. Now go on back.
Sorry I never got you to see your first game in here.
Hell, I've seen too many games in this stadium.
I thought you said you never saw a game.
I've never seen a game from the stands.
You were a player?
I rode the bench for 2 years. Thought I wasn't being played because of my color. I got filled up with a lot of attitude. So I quit. Still not a week goes by, I don't regret it. And I guarantee a week won't go by in your life. You won't regret walking out, letting them get the best of you. You hear me clear enough?
So this week, this is only a test. It's only a test, man. Life is full of tests. I've never known in my life, hear me when I say this, I've never known in my life, or those close to me, that I did not experience growth without some pain. We don't like to hear that. We don't like to talk about it. But it's real and it's the truth. I've never really grown a whole lot when I'm on the mountaintop. Everything is going well. Everything is going smooth. I'm better at that now, at being more consistent than I was 10 years ago. But I'm telling you, the biggest growth in my life is when pain came, when disappointment came. That's when I grew. And I had a good father that told me, you will stand in there and you will fight. And in the worst moments of my life, the worst moment of my life professionally, my father said to me in that worst moment of my life, you are my son, keep standing. That's all he said. He didn't say, man, I'm disappointed in you. He didn't say, man, you got a raw deal. Man, you got shafted. They should have stood with you. He didn't say any of that. All he said to me in my office, I'll never forget it. You're my son, and you keep standing. And I'm saying to you today, whatever you're going through, man, if there's pain involved, if there's disappointment involved, it is an opportunity for you to grow if you'll just keep standing. Just keep standing. Just keep standing. Just keep standing. Don't battle. Don't give in to the lies. Don't give in to it. It's only a test. And if you don't pass the test, you will have another one. When you pass that test, you get a testimony. We didn't pass the test quite last week. I have full confidence. I have, matter of fact, one of my favorite verses in the Bible, Hebrews 12:2, says, for the joy that was set before him, he endured the cross. And I'm telling you, I'm filled with this morning, I can stand before you and honestly say, I'm filled with joy of what I see coming Saturday. I'm full of joy of seeing, man, this group of guys that I love, this group of coaches that I love, this group of football family here that I love. I see with my eyes the joy that is set before us. Now, there's some pain involved. You'll have to strain. You'll have to strain. It won't be easy. It won't always go our way. It may not always go our way today in practice. It certainly won't always go our way come Saturday in the game. But man, I am set in my mind. I see with joy what is set before us. You've got to see that and understand you must strain to pass this test. Three claps for Rip.